and welcome to the Lenovo Work Reborn podcast, where we explore how technology, AI, and cybersecurity are reshaping the way we work. This segment of our tour, we are back at it again, live in London, interviewing top IT leaders. Each episode, we're going to bring you insights from real leaders and industry experts on how organizations can navigate today's challenges and unlock tomorrow's opportunities. From making sense of complex data, to simplifying IT environments, to delivering real business outcomes, Lenovo is helping businesses of every size reimagine what's possible. Join us as we dive into the future of work. Work Reborn. Let's go. Hello and welcome to the Lenovo Work Reborn podcast. My name is Rita. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Rita.
So Noora, I'm so happy that you came by to the booth. I hear that you're going to do a talk soon all about cybersecurity.
Yes, I'm going to be talking about how we need to evolve security culture for our workforce to defend actively against AI-powered threats.
Tell me a little bit about you and what you do, your company and your role.
So at Hoxhunt, what we do is we help basically organizations defend against a human layer of cybersecurity threats. So we help with behavior and culture change. We do phishing training, security awareness training, and the whole host of human risk management, basically.
That's awesome. You know, I think you're a great fit for the show because we have a whole slew of data that we've uncovered after we've interviewed over 600 senior IT leaders about things of this nature, like cybersecurity, AI, risk, and more. Yep. And we got a lot of findings from the report. So we pulled one from it, and I guess we're going to have a quick chat about it. Does that sound good?
Sounds amazing.
Okay, great. So according to Lenovo's Work Reborn survey, more than half of the respondents said that the use of AI by cybercriminals is increasing cybersecurity risk. So, as someone who's training people on this, how is your team thinking about this threat?
Well, obviously, AI has changed the face of how we work. It's also changed the way that the cybercriminals work. So, one notable thing is that it's so much easier to be a cybercriminal these days. You don't need a lot of technical expertise in areas that you might have needed it in the past. You can actually buy ransomware kits on the dark web. You can send out millions of phishing emails that are flawless in language, in any language, where in the past we sort of used to train people to spot spelling mistakes or weird language. That doesn't really happen anymore because criminals are using generative AI to do all of these things for them. And they can actually find out so much information about the victim online and create phishing, social engineering campaigns to target people so individually that it's becoming really, really hard to spot. And of course, the technologies such as deepfakes that are everywhere right now, the use of deepfakes by cybercriminals is going up massively.
Right.
They're using voice cloning as well as video. There's lots of techniques such as callback phishing that they're using. So even when you receive an email, you're asked to call a number for a help desk to reset your password, for example, go straight to the criminals who are, you know, perhaps, you know, posing as somebody you know. So
Right. It's
these are just a few examples, like the sheer scale and the targeted, individualized approach that the criminals are using are, of course, making this problem a lot harder to defend against.
What are some risks that organizations like on the business side should be aware of or maybe red flags to be looking out for?
So I think the biggest red flag is if you're not actively training people to basically defend against these threats, because I think sometimes organizations might feel like, oh, we might not be a target, or they might be a smaller organization or in a geographical area where they don't think perhaps they might be targeted. But of course, for criminals, it's like a numbers game. Mm-hmm. So they'll just target, like with the use of generative AI, where, you know, they can send so many messages that they don't really need to discriminate in terms of who the victim is. So the prevalence is, of course, really high, and the business risk is massive. We know that, like, phishing, for example, is still the primary attack vector used in as an entry point in a successful breach. I think the average cost of a phishing breach caused by phishing is at about 3.8 million this year. AI-powered, basically cyber crime cost is growing by roughly 32% per year. So, like, it's business-wise, it's extremely costly. Most hackers are in it for the money. So they want your money. They will, you know, if you get a ransomware attack, for example, and your data is stolen and you're being basically asked to pay ransom, and you're in that situation where you're either looking to pay that horrible ransom or you have your data all leaked, the risks are, you know, I'm not in the business of trying to scare people, but we need to be aware that those risks are really real and we need to actively defend against them.
Right. I think the awareness is important, especially as the workplace is changing and growing. You know, when we talk about that aspect of workplace change, I'm curious to hear what your own thoughts are on what the future of the workplace looks like. You know, we bringing new life into it. What does Work Reborn mean to you?
So we as humans always need to, I believe, embrace and understand new technological transformations. It's how we've evolved as a humankind, you know, and we need to embrace these changes that AI brings to the workplace. We need to know how to safely use AI solutions. We need to use it in defense as well as in productivity. So I think trying to sort of bury your head in the sand about new technological innovation is the worst thing you can do. You just have to sort of learn to understand enough about it so you don't feel like it's the technology is in the driving seat. I feel like even though technology is enabling us to do more and more amazing things, we need to remain in the driving seat as humans in the workplace.
Yeah, we have to remain in the driving seat and be at the head of change, or we'll be left behind.
Totally agree.
The carpool will leave the station.
Definitely agree. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Noora, for taking your time
today.
If anyone listening to this podcast is interested in learning more about some of the findings from our research report, make sure you check it out. QR code somewhere on the screen available for you to download or available in the description below. And if you'd like to connect with Noora, we'll make sure to have her LinkedIn somewhere in the show notes as well. Thank you so much, Noora.
Thank you, Rita.
Thank you for listening to the Lenovo Work Reborn podcast. To learn more about how Lenovo is helping organizations transform with AI, cybersecurity, and smarter IT solutions, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next conversation. And also, we'd love to hear from you. Make sure to leave a comment with any other questions that you would like us to discuss on our next episodes. See you next time. Lenovo.